In this video, we will show you how to use audio scan in Audirvāna to verify the audio resolution of a track. Only the track being played can be scanned. So let's start one. Audio scan can be found in the extended player view. This view can be opened by clicking on the little square icon here or on the cover artwork of the track. By default, it is showing the regular view, but you can flip the window to display the technical player. Note you can also directly start the scan from the settings of Audirvāna. You can start the scan with the button on the top right side of the window. But first, let's start with a little introduction to digital audio concepts. A sound is a complex waveform of air pressure variation. When recorded, this waveform is captured as an electric sinusoidal signal. In order to digitalize it, to store and stream it as zeros and ones, an analog-to-digital converter takes regular samples on the waveform. The sample rate is the number of points per second expressed in kilohertz. The position of each point, or bit depth, is simply the accuracy of the number defining its position. So more samples with large numbers defining their position means a higher resolution. The cities, for instance, are recorded at 44.1 kHz in 16-bit. So 44,000 samples per second, and each sample has 16 zeros and ones to define its value. This is a standard, and high resolution means a better resolution than this. But why choosing a sample rate of 44.1 kHz in the first place? Because the human ear is capable to hear frequencies up to 20 kHz, and the sample rate needs to be at least the double of the highest frequency you want to record. So it needs to be above 40 kHz for a 20 kHz sound. It is quite easy to understand. If you record a 1 Hz signal, for instance, it cycles in 1 second. If your sample rate is also 1 Hz, you will capture a point always in the same position. So the converter, or DAC, connecting the dots will interpret this as a flat line. But if your sample rate is 2 Hz, then you will have a high point and a low one, and the converter will interpret this as 1 Hz vibration. This is why CDs can't record signals higher than 22 kHz. Finally, one last concept to understand. A low frequency, which carries more energy, varies between higher values than a medium, and obviously a high frequency. If we separate the frequencies of an audio signal and rank them on the horizontal axis from low to high, they would appear like this, shaping a natural descending slope from left to right. And when the frequencies are too high, the values become too small for a given bit depth. So these frequencies are below the noise floor, or maximum dynamic range. The frequency response graph displays exactly that, with a descending slope from left to right. Here we have a typical CD format audio track. It is contained in a darker gray area, limited on the right by the maximum frequencies captured in the recording, around 22 kHz, and below by the smaller values you can record with 16 bits, defining the maximum dynamic range. Because it is an average value, the curve actually can go below this limit. Now, if we play and scan a high-res file, we can see it is contained in a larger, lighter gray area for recordings in 88 or 96 kHz 24-bit. The next area is for recordings with even higher sampling rates up to 912 kHz. In the box on the right, the results of audio scan are summarized. The expected audio quality is reminded first, as defined in the metadata of the file, with the bit depth first, the sampling rate, and the audio format, FLAC, WAVE, AFF, and so on. Below is the quality detected by AudioScan. If it actually matches with the expected quality, it appears in purple with a check sign next to it. Let's say it's a green light, meaning everything seems okay, and you can confirm it visually with the graph. Below is the actual bit depth used in the audio file, then the bandwidth. The channel configuration and the absence of DC issues are also checked. Note that the AudioScan algorithm is not capable to confirm matching for sampling rates above 192 kHz, the SD format and multi-channel track, and has only access to the first unfolding of MQA files. Now, let's check some examples and see what happens when expected and detected quality are not matching. First, this FLAC audio file, for instance, meant to be a 24-bit, 48 kHz recording. We can see the curve is dropping down sharply before the 24 kHz limit. It is a 24-bit recording, but there is some missing information at the end of the spectrum. This is in reality a lossy MP3 file in 320 kilobits per second. Next, we can scan this high-res recording. It shows some real information throughout the audio spectrum, but unlike the one we have displayed before, there is a clear breaking point around 22 kHz, suggesting part of the audio material in the mix was not native high resolution, but rather CD quality. The algorithm qualifies this as semi-high res. Finally, in this last example, we have an obvious case of upsampled CD quality recording. The curve goes up to 88.2 kHz, but everything above 22 kHz is just silence. Upsampling creates samples in between the existing ones, but does not generate harmonics which are not in the recording, at least in this case. If you want more information on AudioScan, you can click on the info icon at the top of the window. Thanks for watching.